ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I say, welcome to another edition of Drag Sports Live. I'm Dante Payne, and we got another exciting edition of Drag Sports Live for you. Those who are new to Drag Sports Live, it's not your typical podcast. It's your podcast with sports and music. And what better way to kick off our show with some music that's from you? Artists that I found on TikTok, that I found on Instagram, and they're upcoming, independent, making their own music, doing the best they can to give us that good music. And I like the music that I hear. I tell you that. I say it all the time. I like the music that I hear from these guys. So let's start our show off right with some music. Then we're going to talk about baseball because the playoffs is on and popping. We're going to talk who's in the NLDS, the ALDS. We're going to talk about it all. Here on Dragon Sports Live, so let's get it cracking.
You gotta get loose to get lifted. Baby, don't get it twisted. You gotta get loose to get lifted. Oh, when I was a child, worry drove me wild. I was
to ride around the city in my whip. Seat laid back in the lack
on the strip.
Had a thing on my hip. She had a blunt on her lip. The armrest had a clip. Yeah. And her purse had a zip. And we just living. We just trying to live it up. Get it fast, spin it fast. We just trying to spend it up. Never had this life before. But I was still wiping flows. Janitor at my high school. The reason I was brand new. My pride low. I mean high. Hella high. I left my classmates. Selling out my five star. Never was in class late. She treated me so good. Homie, she was that great. Pointed out the cool ones and the ones that act fake. I'm like, shawty, you the best. Shout out, you the best. Had me singing down the hallways and my J's looking fresh. She the reason that I got them. She told me they look good on me. So I just kept throwing up the fifth with my hood homies.
I don't know how I got up. Seemed like the best thing that ever happened. Then I realized my problems. Yeah. It's all because of her.
All because of her.
All because of her.
All because of her.
All because of her. Now I got her. Yeah.
So I will
let her go, let her go, let her go.
I will let her go.
Let her go,
yeah.
Let her go, let her go.
Yeah. The hardest thing is a breakup, especially when that's somebody better. I'm a man, do it face to face, I don't need a letter. We've been rocking a long time, but I won't even sweat her. I honestly feel to be with her, I really had to settle. So right now, let's talk it out. For all the years we walked it out, and all the years I followed you, and you don't know what you talk about. You ain't care if I cheat, get as many as I want. Told me to shoot a hater, didn't get mad when I don't. You told me to hit the block with the strap, get the cash, get the chick, forget a man. He can't keep it, wasn't planned. Be heartless regardless, they don't feel me, I'm a target. Finish it if they started. Build a team of Martians. Wait, wait, hold up, wait. You was using me this whole time and I just showed up late. You set up a table for two and plan to kill me today. Where the Lord took your place,
say
walk away,
yeah,
from the plate.
I don't know how I got
up.
Seemed like the best thing that ever happened. Then I realized my problems,
my problems.
Yeah. It's all because of her. Let her go, let her go, let her go.
Said I got
her. Let her go, let her go, let her go.
Let her go, let her go.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Dragon Sports Live. It's going down. It's a exciting show. And we know what it is and what we do. But, like I said before, guys, it's about to go down. It went down in baseball as far as the Astros and Tigers. So, in the American League wildcard series, the Astro Yordan Alvarez was on the roster for the wildcard series, but not designated hitter. Well, he was on there as a designated hitter, but not pitcher Justin Verlander. He was not on the roster. I guess they knew what it was. He was coming back from back tightness and neck tightness and all that discomfort and all that stuff. But they knew what it was. They knew they was done. So it was like, Verlander, rest. We need you for next year if you're coming back, unless you decide you're going to retire. They knew what it was. That's why they didn't put him on the roster. They knew they was going home, but the Tigers end up sweeping them, which is an upset because Astros was number 3, Tigers was number 6. And then in the NDS, or American League DS, Tigers took on the Guardians, where the Guardians took their first lead. They had a bye, so in their first game, they routed. They play again tomorrow, October 7th, at 3:08 p.m., so be sure to watch that game. Right now, like I said, Cleveland leads 1-0 on that. On the other side of that bracket, we got the New York Yankees routing the Kansas City Royals. And they looking good doing it too. I guess to say Ohtani has shined in his playoff debut with the Dodgers. he unleashed a mighty swing and flung his bat fiercely. And Dodgers finished in the beating them 7-5 in that game. So it's like, cool. Ohtani had a homer in that game. The leaves going back and forth. Very close game, guys. Very close game. You got to enjoy that game and embrace it, because it was a very close game. Now, on the other side, in the National League, the New York Mets took the 1-0 lead over the Phillies. They play again today at 3:08 on Fox Sports Net. So be sure to check that out. FS1, baby. FS1. Dodgers take on the Padres later on today. And that's at 7:03. So be sure to watch these games. Be sure to check them out. Be sure, if you're a baseball fan, be sure you keep up on the thing, because we are in the division series final, and then we're going to have the league championships starting the 13th. 2 days after my birthday, by the way, guys. My birthday is coming up, and it's about to get party. It's about to go down. Yes, sir. Going down today. So, let's get it. Let's have some fun. And let's party. Hey. Just, let's do it. MLB legend Pete Rose passed away at 83. He is the career hits leader, controversial for his things, and a lot of people call him that he should be inducted, because he has a Hall of Fame band, so he would not be inducted, but a lot of people calling him that he should be inducted. Like, he should be inducted. Career hits leader, 3 different teams. I'm for it. Induct the man. Give that man what he wants. Bring him into the league. Induct him. That's all I got to say. Induct him. If y'all don't, I will. Induct him, guys. And that's the bottom line. No, but yeah, they should induct him. Get him in there. And let him do what he needs to do. But again, induct him, guys. Induct him. With that being said, induct him. Royals first baseman Vinny Pascuero returns to the roster, which is good for them to have their first baseman back. He was out for quite some time, but it's good to have him back on the roster. Braves pitcher Chris Sale has back tightness, so he was scratched from his start. And it didn't matter, because they got taken out by the Padres. They got swept by the Padres, so it didn't matter. Clam Boone will take over as president of baseball operations. Which, big ups, congrats on that. And then Cubs are making changes. They missed the playoffs for the fifth straight year. So, with that being said, changes had to be made. First baseman Mike Napoli out. Assistant hitting coach Jim Adusi out. Darren Holmes out as coach. So they had to make changes. White Sox haven't really made any moves yet, far as I know. But changes has come. Speaking of changes, Terry Francona is coming out of retirement to manage the Reds. Now remember, he's the former Atlanta Braves manager. Retired due to health issues and stuff like that. But he's coming out of retirement to manage the Reds. Diamondbacks also shaking up their coaching staff after missing the playoffs. Pitching coach Brent Storm out. Bullpen coach Mike Fetters is out. They said, we cutting ties, we letting people go. It would better us, the team, and it would better us all. But we are cutting loose all things possible. Especially if you have the worst hit offensive team in the league. Yeah, change is going to be made. And that's how you got to look at it. Change is going to be made. So, that's all you got to do is look at it. But you want to know what's crazy? Four-time manager of the year wants to manage the White Sox. Y'all say who? I don't know. Let's see. Who would manage the White Sox? But Buck Showalter is angling for the manager's job for the Chicago White Sox. And we can see that happen, but they would need somebody that is strong, don't mind shaking up the roster to make to get things done. And you got somebody interested in, so let's see what they do. Like, let's see what they're gonna do about that. Like, yeah, let's double check and see what they gonna do, because Buck Showalter says he's interested. I say go for it. But let's see, because it's gonna be a long season. Long season. Just because we don't know what's going on with that. It's going to be a long off season. It is what it is. But let's give y'all some more music here on Drug Sports Live. I got Strange Neighbors, Lisa, You're Tearing Me Apart here on Drug Sports Live. Check it out, guys. Followed by Peyton Parrish, Can You Feel The Coming Up. Here we go. We'll be right back.
surrender to the rush of day. When the heat of a rolling wind can be turned away, and the chanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior.
Welcome back, guys. I was not paying attention, almost tweet looking at some videos where they comparing McDonald's chicken nuggets to all that. But speaking of the chicken nuggets, the children, the athletes on the college level are having a time of their lives. We got Midwest Conference making an update. Basically, they now have 7 full-time schools in there, because UTEP joins Midwest Conference, the NWC. So now they're trying to get full-time schools. You got some schools that only football there or only basketball is in that conference, and everything else is in a different conference, but we're moving. So Florida State quarterback DJ Onwuale, he has a broken finger on his throwing hand, and Brock Green had got the start in place of DJ this past Saturday. Big Ten alters onside kicking, the onside kick officiating after Minnesota-Michigan's game ended. So now the line and headline judge will be placed on the kicking team's restraining line. So you'll have more eyes on the ball and basically won't have a backle or a penalty that was thrown or something like that. You got more eyes that can be able to see the play clearly and versus what it was before, which caused a controversial ending. Cool. Purdue, they fired offensive coordinator Graham Harwell due to the lack of points scored in FBS competition. They said, you did good last year, but this year, you got to go. Like I said, lack of points scored, they scored like, they averaged like 27 points in 3 weeks already. And that's total of the three games that they played. Yeah, they was trying to make changes. Alabama overtakes Texas for the number one spot in the AP Top 25. But they lost to Vanderbilt the other day. It was a close game. Came down to the wire. But Vanderbilt succeeded. Won, thus getting their first win against a top AP top 5 team. They're 1-60 against the top 25. Well, they was 0-60 until yesterday when Vanderbilt took over, won against Alabama. Now they're 1-60 against the top 25. See how things work in mysterious ways? That's the power of God. Works that they got their first victory and also got against the number one ranked victory, so they was unranked. So that is the big upset of the day. We got more upsets of the day that happened that yesterday as well, because I don't know if y'all was watching, I definitely was watching, but I seen a lot of decent upsets. Like, I was looking at the scores, looking at standing. We had Texas A&M destroy Missouri. They got in there. So I was definitely enjoying that yesterday. Like I said, Vanderbilt over Alabama. Arkansas over Tennessee. Tennessee is ranked 4. Arkansas wasn't. Georgia got in that grind. Miami, Carolina, that game was a close game. It came down, it was 1 point differential, 39-38. Washington got defeated Michigan. So it was like, and both of these teams are in Big Ten 4-2, 2-1 in Big Ten play. Hey. I like when I see upsets. I love looking at upsets, to be honest. Like, I love waking up and seeing an upset in the Razorbacks in they drought. Like I said, when they beat Tennessee versus top 5 teams, so they ended that drought, they had that. Genty continues his historic run. Boise State running back Ashton Genty continues a record-chasing run to Heisman Trophy frontrunner status Saturday night as he and number 21 Broncos 62-30 win over the visiting Utah State. Genty has surpassed 1,000 yards rushing on the season on just his 90th carry, produced 186 rushing yards and 3 touchdowns on 13 attempts in the first half in that blowout win. He has tied FBS record in needing just 5 games to achieve 1,000 yards. He has rushed for 1,031 yards, 16 touchdowns, averaging 10.9 yards per carry, for the Broncos this season. Boise State. And is now averaging 206 rushing yards per game. He's running his butt off. Put him in line for the Heisman Trophy, guys. Put him in line. Because he's running his butt off. I just say he's definitely running his butt off. But it is what it is. Keep doing that work. Keep doing what you got to do. NCAA penalized Raiders head coach Antonio Pierce for Arizona State University violations. He's sanctioned just like Tyler Hansbury. Can't have no part of that. Can't attend the event. So, hey, he'll be all right. He'll be all right. That's all you got to say. He'll be all right. It'll be okay. He got to focus on football anyways. He got quarterback situation. They still sticking with Gardner Mitchell as the starter in there. And they had a tough game today. So, that's the crazy part. They got a tough game. They got... They played the Broncos today. So, it ain't gonna necessarily... I ain't gonna say it's tough, but both these teams are 2-2. It's gonna be an interesting game. Bo Nix versus Gardner Mitchell. Who's gonna win? Davante Adams is out. Now, he's out due to hamstring tightness, but in other news, he also kind of requested the trade and influenced the trade. Like, he wants to join Aaron Rodgers. He wants to go back with his teammate Derek Carr. He wants out of Oakland. As much as he tried not to say it, he wants out of Oakland. And with that being said, we had Max Crosby, who was questionable. Luke Madsen, the linebacker, he's on IR, so he won't be back until November 3rd. Tyreek McAllister is questionable. Divine Debo is questionable. Broncos got Tyler Batty, IR, Alex Singleton, IR, Baron Browning, IR, and Mike McClitchy, IR, as well as Otterick Esme on IR. One player won't return to the 17th. One, February 10th. But they on IR. But Raiders are trying to go for their 9th consecutive win over the AFC West rival. Can they do it? That's all you gotta say is, can they do it? I think they can, but yeah, can they do it? So we'll see what goes from that, where it goes, but Broncos, they are coming off a win against the Jets, the 10-9 win, so, and they also beat Tampa Bay 26-7, so they kind of hungry right now. That game's happening at 3:05 on Fox in the Pacific area. Right now, we got the Minnesota Vikings taking on the New Jets with the Vikings in the lead 17-10 into the first. Aaron Rodgers has thrown 2 interceptions already. Sam Darnold is 11-20 with 128 yards on the game. So we'll see how that goes from now. Justin Jefferson only got 61 yards on 4 receptions, which is great because he about to have 100 yards soon. Bears play at 12 today. They're taking on Carolina, that 1-3. And I got to say, this is a must-win game for the Bears. Reason I'm saying that, you know, we traded with this team twice. Antonio Dalton, who's a former Bears quarterback, is with Panthers. He already has 5 INTs and 1 interception in the first four games. We got Caleb Williams with 3 TDs and 4 interceptions in his first couple games coming into that. We don't want to lose to the Panthers. I'm sorry, we don't. But the Bears got quite a few players that's inactive. Valus Jones Jr., he's inactive. Terrell Smith is inactive. Dominique Robinson is inactive. Zach Pickens is inactive. And Kahari Bazemi is inactive, the fullback. I don't want to see it, guys. As far as the Panther side, Russ Yee, safety, inactive. Andrew Ram, inactive. Jaden Pavey, offensive tackle Jerry Kingston, and Josie Jowell are all inactive for the game. So they healthy scratch, but I just don't want to see it. I don't want to see it at all. We got other games that's happening today as well, because it's a full season. With Pittsburgh taking on Dallas later on today, and that game's going to be on NBC Peacock. That's at 7:20. It's the late game. Dallas, on the other hand, going to be without DeMarcus Lawrence, who they placed on IR with LaFrenzic injury, which is in the foot. He avoids surgery, but he is on IR. They, in that move, they sign defense end KJ Henry off the Bengals practice squad. So it's like the struggle is real for Dallas. Yeah, struggle is definitely real for Dallas, because they're going to be without inactives. They're missing key players in their game. So you missing Brandon Cooks, one of your wide receivers, Michael Parsons, Maurice LaFou is questionable, and so is Trayvon Diggs. He's questionable. Still is going to be with, still got Russell Wilson questionable, Jeremiah Moon questionable, Mecole Pruitt questionable. Well, Mecole Pruitt out, and Jaylen Warren running back out, Cordell Patterson out. Now these guys suffer high ankle sprains, so they are out until the 13th. That's when they can return, but we're going to see Dak Prescott versus Justin Fields from the looks of it. Hey, let's check it out, guys. Let's definitely check it out. Defensive end. Tyquan Lewis, he's on IR with an elbow injury. So he won't be active today when they take on the Jaguars, who's 0-4. I don't know what's going on with the Jaguars, but they need some help. They definitely need some help. Coach said he does value change, and he can even go from quarterback, but they need some help. Because they're 0-4 and they can't seem to go. They hope to end their skid against the banged up Colts, who not only is they missing Tyquan Lewis, but Anthony Richardson, the QB, is out. Jonathan Taylor, the running back, is out. Kwity Paye, the defensive end, is out. Anthony Gold, wide receiver, is out. And Kenny Moore, the second cornerback, is out. So all the other guys, like, other than Go, all the other guys are out until the 13th. So we'll see what that goes, but they pretty banged up. Hopefully the Jaguars can get a win, because all their games been blowouts. The last one they got was back in August, on August 23rd against the Falcons, when it was 31-0. They haven't won since then. So, hey, we gotta do what we gotta do, guys. Y'all gotta do what y'all gotta do. Not we, I ain't. Y'all gotta do what y'all gotta do to get better. Chargers wide receiver Rashee Rice was injured in the last game, possible ACL tear, but the injury was caused by his own teammate, Patrick Mahomes. Now, Patrick Mahomes didn't know that he was the one who caused the injury after reviewing the in-play, but he was trying to brace for the impact, not knowing that, like, he was basically at the wrong spot at the wrong time, and he just was trying to brace for impact and end up hurting his own teammate. But hopefully they're going to run some tests on that, and we're going to see what, like, what's going on with his knee. But yeah, they'll be without Rashee Rice. Still without Pacheco and Kai Ehlers-Alaire. So in that move, they brought up Kareem Hunt and to do some running back duties. And there's going to be a running back by committee. Duties going to split between their rookie and more. So we'll see. We'll check up. I'll keep y'all posted on that. Other news, though, wide receiver Odell Beckham Jr., he's set for his first practice as a Dolphin since being signed in May. He had an undisclosed injury that they didn't really say. But, like I said, he was set for his first practice. He is active today against my New England Patriots. But my New England Patriots are going to be out with Javon Breaker, KJ Osborne, Kyle Duggar, my safety, and Joe Minn the third, my backup QB, with as well as Jim Reed Comar, my defensive end. So, like I said, he is out. He did practice. We might see Odell suit up for the Dolphins today against the Patriots. We shall see. We'll find out. I'll be at work. I'll probably watch the game while I'm at work. Or tune into it, listen to it, and then work resourcefully. Bills defensive end Von Miller is suspended 4 games due to personal conduct. This was basically the thing when he choked his baby mama and all that stuff that happened months ago last year, and they decided to suspend him for 4 games. Browns defensive tackle Mike Hall Jr. is also suspended 5 games for personal conduct. And these guys, like, same thing. Personal conduct policy, not abiding by the rules. So now they got to pay the consequences and do it like that. Recording smarter move, Bills signed defensive tackle Zion Logue to them. Titans Jeffrey Simmons is back from TJ Lindgren injury. So welcome him back. And the Seahawks add offensive tackle Jason Peters to the practice squad. Probably going to end up elevating him to another level. But we'll see. Check out these games. Cincinnati taking on Ravens tonight or at 12. A lot of these games is happening at 12. But the late cap, yeah, is going to be Dallas and Pittsburgh. We got New York Giants taking on Seattle, with Seattle 3-1. So it's like, it's interesting because people that's normally at the top of the standings in the first couple weeks, not at the top. So we'll see. Like I said, Jaguars is the only team that's undefeated. Vikings and Kansas City are the only two undefeated teams currently still in the league. So I give y'all more updates. Stay tuned for another football update next week. But in between time, meantime, we gonna give y'all some more music here on Drug Sports Live. We gonna give y'all Sable Alexis, Pieces of a Man, here on Drug Sports Live. Check it out, y'all.
Oh, my. pieces of a man. I gotta love a pussy down in the bed. Intellectuals inside of my head. I got a chef who satisfied my foodie. A good friend for a dinner in the morning. I got a gentleman to take me to the gala. A good provider puts food on my table. I got a looker takes my breath away. I got a boss who never lets me pay. One good man. What I got is pieces of man. Too many men to satisfy my needs, but one good man will bring me to my knees. Without all the baggage. Ooh, I got a joker who always wants to play. A man of faith
who ain't afraid to pray.
When it breaks, a real charmer
who got what it takes.
One good man. What I got is pieces of man. Too many men to satisfy my needs, but one good man will bring me to my knees. One good man will bring me to my knees. What I want is a real good man. What I got is pieces of man. Too many men to satisfy my needs, but one good man will bring me to my knees. Just give me one.
Okay, well, enough about that. Do you have a pool? Brother, you got a thing you could swim in, splash. You got that?
Don't have a pool. Got it.
I thought I had, yes.
But we got a 10-mile lake out back. Lake? Call it Lake Varnell. Yes, catfish are delicious.
Thank you.
Welcome back, guys, to another edition of Dragon Sports Live. That last song you heard was Devil's Advocate by brother Rick here on Dragon Sports Live. And if you missed Dragon Sports Live, don't feel bad because you ain't missed it. You can go to Spotify, Apple Podcasts, iHeartRadio, or wherever you get your podcast at. You can also catch it on YouTube at Dragon Jump Pro on YouTube, guys. So don't feel bad if you missed it. You ain't missed nothing. It ain't it. You can catch it again. But with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, we are in the playoffs in the WNBA. And the playoffs is starting out pretty. It's pretty good. It's been pretty good for the women's tip. We are in the second round now where the Aces was not going down to fight. New York Liberty led the way 2-0, and then Aces was like, no, we're not backing down. We're staying alive. But they play again today at 2 p.m. on ABC. It was there. Even the Sun came back because even the Lynx was 2-0 on that. Sun came back. bounce back. So that series tied 1-2. And hey, we got some awards to hand out, guys. So I already mentioned before on my previous show that Las Vegas Aces Aja Wilson is the MVP. Like, she's the second unanimous second player to be a unanimous decision. First since Cynthia Cooper. So that's your MVP. Right? Rookie of the Year is Caitlin Clark. And Coach of the Year is Cheryl Reeve of the Minnesota Lynx. Defensive Player of the Year is Nafisa Clark, Carly of the Minnesota Lynx. Sixth Player of the Year is Leonie Fibich of New York Liberty. So, and Most Improved Player is DeJounte Carrington. Your all WNBA first team, Aja Wilson, Nafisa Carter, Breonna Stewart, Caitlin Clark, Caleb McBride. But yeah, those people going up into the Raptors. Well, not Raptors, but getting awards as far as in the women's side of things. They getting those awards. They earned it. They worked hard and they played their butts off this season. So, well, I'm my bad. Six woman of the year is Tiffany Hayes. So, yeah. We got quite a few coaching openings. So we got the Chicago Sky opening after they fired Cheryl Swoops. I mean Teresa Weatherspoon. Wow, Cheryl Swoops. Teresa Weatherspoon. We got Kirk Miller and the LA Sparks got their opening because they fired Kirk Miller. And the Golden State Valkyries, since that's a new team, they have coach open. They yet to name a coach yet. And a few more. Indiana Fever hired Amber Cox as the team's chief operating officer and general manager of the franchise on Friday. Cox will succeed current GM Lynn Dunn, who will move into a new position as senior advisor for the team. And that's the first move of Kelly since she rejoined the team as president of basketball operations. So that's a good thing. But that's what's going on with that. Dream fired coach Tanisha Wright after another first round sweep. And that was announced this past Wednesday. So, that's another team to hope. So, you got Dream, Sky, Sparks, Sun, all openings. Brittany Griner will be joining Unrivaled, which is a new 3-on-3 basketball league for WNBA players this offseason. In their offseason. That Griner is the 24th player in the fold. It's a 30-player league and it's starting in January. All games played in Miami over a 10-week span on a 60-foot court. The participant would be divided into six teams of five players. So that's a, you know, that's a good thing. You keeping busy, staying true to what you need to do. And basically, yeah, staying true to what you need to do. That's definitely a thing. Gonzaga will be joining the Pac-12 in 2026. And St. Louis center Robbie Avell to miss a couple weeks with an ankle injury. Got a couple injuries because even on the NBA side, Grizzlies power forward center Jaren Jackson, he's out with a hamstring injury. Bulls guard Lonzo Ball said his goal is to be ready by opener. He's been doing a lot of 5-on-5 and full contact drills all summer. So he's hoping to be ready for the opener, minus hoping it with no setbacks. He's ready, and he's ready to conquer. So we'll see how that goes. Preseason has started with the Lakers playing Bronny James, getting some tick. And LeBron did not play that game, so we didn't have the father and son on the court at the same time. But they're there, and we lost the legend. Hall of Famer Dikembe Mutombo passed away at the age of 58 due to complications with brain cancer that he was fighting. So we lost the finger wag, the greatest thing, but he left the legacy. He's been an advocate for basketball overseas, African Basketball League. He's been doing it all. So we lost that, but condolences goes out to the family. We'll never forget the iconic moments. The finger wag. We got it all. But Kawhi says his knee is good, taking things slowly. Blazers guard Sharp is out 4 to 6 weeks with a shoulder injury. So, hey, Union rejoins the Knicks as the basketball ambassador. Welcome back to New York, Patrick Union. We had that blockbuster trade that sent Karl-Anthony Towns to Knicks, but Thibodeau's history helps transition with the Knicks a little bit easier because Tibbs coached Cat when he was in Minnesota. So, hey. But Julius Randle says he feel wanted here at Minnesota. Rondo eyeing future joins Bucks as guest coach on the Milwaukee Bucks at training camp. So that's a good thing. They at training camp right now, and we'll see what it goes about, what comes about. But ain't nothing too much happening in the NBA right now. We did have the Nuggets take on the Boston Celtics for preseason, with the Celtics coming away with the 130-104 win. Tatum had 17 points. White 13, Brown had 21, Cormack had 5, and Holiday had 7. Sam Howell's off the bench with 15, Pritchard with 14, Xavier Tillman with 10. Now, Horford didn't play, nor did Porzingis play. But, like I said, preseason. Guys, got to keep that in mind. It's preseason, so keep that in mind. We season kicks off on the 22nd, so we not too far away. Basketball is here, and I keep y'all updated with all the news. But until then, catch me on another edition of Drug Sports Live. I'm Dante Payne. Peace out.